I welcome back everyone. Today in this class we are going to discuss about the value added network. Over the years, a common and convenient method for conducting EDI has emerged into value added network, or it can be called as VAN, V-A-N. The general reason a company subscribes to a VAN will be mainly two. First one, smooth provision of network services, and the second one, to facilitate electronic data interchange. The services which are included under VAN is EDI translation, encryption, secure email, management reporting, and other extra services for their customers. Once a company subscribes to a VAN, it should provide some of the services. The services are called EDI translation. That is, the data which is to be transmitted should be transmitted electronically. That is the first service. Second one, encryption. While we transfer the data as electronically, it should be in secured form. For that, it needs some encryption. That is also provided. And even though it is encrypted in a secured form, the transmission should be done in secured manner. For that, it is providing secure email. And during the process, if the subscriber having any complaint, it should be reported to the management and it should be recovered. So all these services are provided under VAN. The services provided by value added networks in brief manner are as follows. The first services, document conversion. The document conversion from one standard to another. So we have discussed already some of the standard format for documentation, isn't it? So here the document from one format can be converted to another format. That is the first service given here. When two trading partners required to use different standards for EDI exchange, it needs to be converted from one format to another format. For example, we could say ANSI ASK X12 to EDI FACT. Next, the second service is converting one ANSI ASK X12 document to another ANSI AC X12 document. This can be done when it needs to be converted to another type within the same system itself. The third service is the sender may follow certain conventions that are different from the receiver. Conventions are generally known as protocol or agreements that can be different from one firm to another firm. One firm may be sender and another firm may be receiver. So it could be different from one company to another company. For those situations also, VAN provides translation from a sender's conventions of a standard document to the receiver's conventions. That is, what are the thing will be done here is translate field separators and then discard unwanted characters, then format translation from EDI standard to or from flat file to flat file, XML and other formats. And finally, data translation among the PDF, XLS, MDB or other web-based documents. Okay, field, in the sense we know the separators for column are to represent the specific category. Okay, so it may be translated, and unwanted, if there is any unwanted characters, it can be discarded. The standard format can be different from one person to another person. At that time it should be translated, isn't it? If one's document is in XML format, another may need in another standard format. At that time it should be translated from one format to another format, and also that in another standard format. At that time it should be translated from one format to another format, and also that data translation can be done from PDF to XLS, XLS to PDF, and MDB. MDB is nothing but material designed for bootstrap. So there are many data format which can be used for web-based documents. So all these things can be done as a third service, that is conversion from one conventions to another conventions. The fourth service is the appropriate customer data can be saved in the VAN account and later appended on messages where required. The customer's data could be received from their application and can be stored on VAN account. Later, when they send the message, the stored data can be sent along with the message. For example, sender's bill of lading number can be stored in the account, that is VAN account. Then later, acknowledgement message including the BOL number can be sent to the sender. So likewise, the required data can be stored on the VAN account. Then later it can be sent along with a message to the sender. The fifth service is, as like storing sender's data in VAN account, the provider's computers also store the data in VAN account, such as customer profiles, repetitive variable codes, etc., which can also be used for filling up the EDI transaction document with the help of the customer profile code. This customer profile can be accessed using the customer profile code on the VAN, and these data which is in profile can be used for completing the EDI transaction. Then sixth service is, subscribers can interactively inquire the management about the status of any EDI transaction made by them. The subscriber can track their transaction with the management. What about the status of transaction? Then the seventh service is, subscribers can receive verify acknowledgments in the mailbox even when they are not in online. They might not be in online, but they will get the alert message, that is verify acknowledgments, from the mailbox. Next, eighth service is, the VAN can alert the subscriber that there is data in their mailbox to be picked up. How the subscriber receives the verify acknowledgement from mailbox. Likewise, the VAN can also alert the subscriber that they are having some data in mailbox. It can be done by either sending a fax notification or by calling a pager or other alerting devices that signal users about the waiting mail in the mailbox. They can use either fax notification or calling a pager to alert the subscriber that there is a message or data for them. This is the eighth service. Next, the ninth service is, the VAN can capture the specified data from transactions. Then it can be used for generating customer specified reports. The required data can be captured from the transaction from sender to receiver, and it can be used later for generating customer specified reports. And the 10th service is, subscriber can also ask for the editing requirements which can be edited by the VAN for completeness and correctness as per requirements. In case if there is any mistakes or the data which is not according to the user requirements, that is subscriber requirements, then it should be corrected, isn't it? For that, the VAN provides a service to edit the requirement according to the subscriber. For example, it can verify that the line item charges on an invoice add up to the total value shown on the EDI invoice. Invoice is nothing but a list of goods sent or services provided with the statement of the sum due for this. Or simply, we can say that invoice is a bill. Okay. The 11th service is, there are some situations where such missing or mismatching data is found during the edit process. At that time, the VAN usually send messages to the originator informing it about the missing or mismatched data and the request retransmission of the same. If the VAN found any missing or mismatching data, it will be intimated to the originator and asking for retransmission and will ask for retransmission of the same. Next, the 12th service is, validate and verify the information which is stored in customers' databases for missing data and send messages to appropriate firms requesting correction of the missing data. Once the VAN asked for retransmission for missing or mismatching data, it should be verified and validated in the customer's database, and it should be corrected from the data which is stored in customer's database. So these are the services which is provided by the VAN for EDI. Now here there are many third party VAN providers for the marketplace. We can see some of them here. First one, GEIS, which is operated by General Electric of USA. GEIS has presence in over 50 countries. It is presented over 50 countries. GE, as the major trader of goods from top corporations of the world, has brought major trade partners on a van. So this is the first third party VAN provider. Next one, Cable and Wireless. Highly reliable. It is highly reliable with a subscriber base of over 2000 top companies of the world. Cable and Wireless holds nearly 8% market share of the global VAN market. This is also one of the top most third party VAN provider. The third one, GNS. It is one of the largest value added network and has presence in around 36 countries. The fourth one is Transpac. This is a France-based EDI van provider. Transpac owns the largest domestic van market share and has a strong presence in Europe. It is known as the largest domestic van market share. This is commonly known as the largest domestic van provider. The fifth one is Infonet. Infonet is a van service which is jointly owned and operated by WorldCom, Singapore Telecom and Transpac. So all these three are jointly owned this Infonet VAN provider. Next, the sixth one, Satyam Infoway. This is the first private national internet service provider to offer EDI VAN services in India in association with the Sterling Software of USA. It is associated with Sterling Software of USA. Next one, NICNet. This is the National Informatics Center. It is an arm of Indian Ministry of Information Technology, has established connectivity through 600 points in India. The NIC network interconnects all the state capitals and district headquarters through its network. Later in 1999, the NIC net started offering value-added networks services. So this is also one of the famous and commonly used VAN provider. These are commonly known as the third party VAN providers. So here in this class we have discussed about the value added networks which is used to achieve the proper EDI, that is electronic data interchange. To achieve the proper electronic data interchange, we need the help of VAN, which provides some of the services. So we have discussed the services what are provided by VAN in this class, and also we have seen some of the private VAN providers. Okay, I'll meet you next class. Thank you.